start with another important session from these chapters, D and L block elements. In previous session, what we discussed, electronic configuration of D block element, followed by oxidation state and properties of D block elements. And after that, in next session, what we discuss, different properties of D block element. We starts with first important property, that is reducing properties of D block element, and what we finished last time, second one, catalytic properties of D block elements. So in today's session we are going to continue these properties, like formation of interstitial compounds, then color properties, magnetic properties, after that complex formation tendency, and last point we are going to discuss in today's session, that is expected and actual electronic configuration of two elements, Cr and Cu, means why there is difference in expected and actual configuration. So let us start with first point. What is next property of D block element we are going to consider? Formation of interstitial compound. So remember here, D block elements have tendency, which tendency? To entrap atoms of other element in order to form which compound? Interstitial compound. Suppose these are D block element particles, then what happen? In between these there is presence of smaller particles, so due to entrapping of atoms of other element in between them, they have tendency to form which compounds? Interstitial compounds. Remember, these interstitial particle may be from carbon, nitrogen or hydrogen. For first level MCQ, remember, this gets entrapped in case of D block element, forming what type of compound? Interstitial compound. And what these interstitial particles belongs to element? Carbon, nitrogen and hydrogen. And in addition to this, remember important feature of this interstitial compound, these are non-stoichiometric. Anybody can tell me meaning of this one? Interstitial compounds are what type of compounds? Non-stoichiometric compounds, means particles, that is cation and anions, are not in exact proportion, there may be somewhat deviation, that is known to be non-stoichiometric compound. And what type of bonding you are expecting? It is neither covalent nor found to be ionic. In which compound? Interstitial compound. So in addition to this, remember other properties of interstitial compound. These are having very high physical constant, MP value, these are found to be very high. Then these are found to be very hard as compared to original metals. After that, they possess which property? Conductivity property. And what is another important one? They are chemically inert. So remember, these are few important properties of interstitial compound. These are non-stoichiometric compound, bonding neither covalent nor ionic, their physical constant values are found to be higher, these are found to be very hard compound, possess conductivity, and they are less reactive, that is chemically inert. Shift towards next point. Color properties. So can you tell me what do you mean by color of D block element? Remember this explanation. Suppose this is understudy metal, it is exposed to light. So when incident light falls upon metal surface, what happens? Certain radiations gets absorbed while remaining radiation gets transmitted. So this color of transmitted light appears to our eyes, and that gives you color of corresponding D block metal. So remember, which two phenomena are responsible? Absorption and transmission of light. So remember here, metal surface is exposed to which light? Incident light. Out of that incident light, only certain radiation gets absorbed, remaining radiation gets transmitted, and this color of transmitted light appears to our naked eyes, and that is known to be color of the D block element. Remember, in this case for MCQ, this one, DD electron transition is responsible for which property? color properties of the D block elements. Now for MCQ purpose, remember this thing, very important. Those species which are having at least one unpaired electron, they are found to be colored. While those species which do not have unpaired electron, or all the electrons are in paired condition, they are found to be colorless. So this important hint we are going to use in MCQ discussion. No unpaired electron or all electrons in paired condition, it is definitely colorless species. And if species is found to be colored, then it should possess at least one unpaired electron. So let us explain this condition. First of all, we are starting with this example. Suppose we take Fe plus 3. Can you tell me what is configuration of Fe atomic number 26, argon 18, 4s 2, 3d 6. Now, what is charge on ion? Plus 3. So equal electron should be lost. So 2 electrons from 4s will be lost, 1 electron from 3d will be lost. What will be remaining configuration? 3d5. In case of which ion? Fe plus 3. Now, check this block diagram. What this 3d5 indicate? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is presence of which electron? Unpaired. So this particle, that is Fe plus 3 ion, it is found to be colored. Remember, it is found to be colored. Now, if we check example of this one, copper plus ion. Can you tell me what happened in case of copper plus? Copper chromium shows 4s1, not 4s2. So it become argon 18, 4s1. What is this? 3d10. What type of charge? Plus 1. So there is loss of 1 electron from which orbital? 4s. So what should be remaining configuration? 3d10. Now, how to indicate 3d10 configuration? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As per Hund's rule, all orbitals are singly filled. 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So there is absence of which electron? Unpaired. So it is found to be colorless. Remember, this is the example of which species? Colorless species. Similarly, we can explain other examples. Suppose we take this one, another particle. That is Mn plus 2 ion. Tell me configuration. Argon 18, 4s2, 3d5. How to obtain this Mn plus 2 ion? You should lose 2 electrons to form Mn plus 2. Now 2 electrons are lost from which orbital? 4s2. So these 2 electrons will be lost. Once again, what you are getting? 3d5. Now indicate this block diagram for 3d5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there is again presence of which electron? Unpaired. So it is found to be colored. Remember this one. Now, if we take another example, check this. This is which ion? Zn plus 2 ion. Can you tell me atomic number 30? Argon 18, 4s2. So it became 3d10. Now, in order to form Zn plus 2, there should be loss of 2 electron. How 2 electron will be lost? From 4s. So what remain here? 3d10. Now tell me in 3d10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. There is absence of unpaired electron, so it is found to be colorless. So in case of MCQ, only there may be change in cation or the compound, and you have to identify whether it is colored or colorless. Let us shift towards another important property for MCQ discussion. What is that? Magnetic property. So we are going to discuss two important conditions, that is diamagnetism and paramagnetism. In physics also you came across these two terms. So remember, in diamagnetism what happened? It is the phenomenon in which substance or the species is weakly repelled in magnetic field. What about reverse condition in paramagnetism? Substance or the species is weakly attracted in magnetic field. That phenomenon is paramagnetism. But for MCQ discussion, remember here, in case of diamagnetism and paramagnetism, here unpaired electron is absent or all electrons are in paired condition. But in case of weakly attraction in magnetic field, that is paramagnetism, there is presence of what type of electron? Unpaired. Similar condition, color property, paramagnetic, colorless property, diamagnetism, presence and absence of unpaired electron. So let us explain this magnetic property of D block element with respect to this example. Suppose we are dealing with scandium plus 3 ion. Can you tell me Sc plus 3? What is the atomic number of scandium? 21. So what we can write? Argon 18, 3D1, 4S2. What type of charge we are expecting here? Plus 3. So equal electron should be lost. How these 3 electrons will get lost? 2 from 4S, 1 from 3D. So what should be configuration here? 3D0. So there is absence of unpaired electron. It is repelled in magnetic field. That is diamagnetic. What about second species if you take this one? Nickel plus 2 ion. Tell me nickel 28, argon 18, 4s2. So what did it become? 3d8. In order to develop plus 2 charge, there is loss of 2 electron from 4s orbital. So what remain here? 3d8. Now tell me 3d8 configuration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Remaining undergoes pairing. 6, 7, 8. What you are getting here? There is presence of unpaired electron. So it is found to be paramagnetic in nature. Can you tell me? If we provide other examples, cation, you should be able to tell me whether it is diamagnetic or paramagnetic. So let us check this example. Another one. Titanium plus 4. What is Ti? Titanium. Atomic number 22. So again it becomes argon 18, 4s2, 3d2. So in order to develop which charge? Plus 4. 4 electrons should be lost. How? 2 from 4s, 2 from 3d. So once again what you are getting? 3d0. There is absence of unpaired. And again it is found to be diamagnetic in nature. Suppose we take another example. If we write this one. Cobalt plus 3 ion. Tell me cobalt 27, argon 18, 4s2, 3d7. In order to form plus 3 charge, there should be loss of 3 electron. 2 from 4s, 1 from 3d. So what it remain? 3d6. Now indicate block diagram for 3d6 as per Hund's rule. First of all the orbitals are singly filled. 5, 6. What this indicate? There is presence of unpaired electron. It gets attracted in magnetic field. So it is found to be paramagnetic in nature. So you should be able to identify in case of MCQs whether species is diamagnetic or paramagnetic. Then we will going to discuss another important point. That is complex formation tendency. Remember, in case of paper 2, organic chemistry, section 2, there is separate unit, coordination compound. At that time, you should familiar with these important terms. So remember, how D block element have tendency to form different complexes. So for MCQ, remember, D block elements have tendency to form different complexes. Why these have tendency to form different complexes? Remember first one. D block metal cation have very smaller size. What about charge? Charge on this particle is found to be higher. Smaller size, greater charge. So that result in which factor? Increase in charge density. Why charge density increase? Size is very very small. And what about charge? Higher. So there is increase in charge density. In addition to this one, remember there is presence of vacant d orbital. So that what happen? They can accept electrons donated by incoming groups. These are called as ligands. So remember for MCQ, d block elements have greater tendency to form various complexes on account of smaller size, greater charge and presence of what type of orbital? It is must. It is very necessary. Vacant d orbital, so that they can easily accept electron donated by the ligands. Now if we check different examples, there are different types of complexes, that is positively charged complexes, then negatively charged complexes, then chargeless, that is neutral complexes. Suppose we take this one, K3FeCN6. Can you tell me? Each CN carries minus 1 charge. So how many cyanides are there? 6, minus 6 charge. Each potassium carries plus 1. 3 ions are there, so plus 3. So what it become? Plus 3. That is potassium ferric cyanide. Now check this one. Plus 6 minus 6 gets cancelled. This complex has no charge on it, so it belongs to neutral category. What about examples of positively charged complex and negatively charged complex? Suppose we take this one, ZnNH3 4 times plus 2. What it indicate? Ammonia is found to be neutral ligand. So what is charge here? 0. So what may be the charge present on complex that belongs to D block metal? So it is example of positively charged complex. Now if we are dealing with negatively charged complex, check this example. Platinum Cl6 minus 2. What it indicate? Each Cl carries minus 1, minus 6. Out of minus 6, minus 2 is remain. So what happened? Platinum carries what type of charge? Plus 4 charge. So remember, in case of D block element, these have tendency to form various complexes on account of this factor. And what are the examples? Positively charged complex, negatively charged complex, or complexes having no charge at all. Then we will move towards another point. This is also important point for theoretical discussion as well as for MCQs. Remember, which two elements from first transition series shows difference in their expected and actual electronic configuration? First member is Cr. What is second member? Cu. Chromium and copper shows differences in their expected and actual configuration. If we shift towards first element, chromium, what is atomic number? 24. So what we can write? Cr24 argon. So what did it become? As per expectation, argon 18 plus 2, 20. So it become 3d4. So if we indicate a block diagram for 4s, this is 4s having which electron? 2 electron. What about 3D? Tell me, 3D4. 1, 2, 3, 4. What happened? Last orbital is vacant. So this is block diagram for expected configuration. But in order to fulfill exactly half filled condition, one electron is transferred here. So what actual configuration we are getting here? 4S2 instead of that 4S1, and instead of 3D4 it become 3D5. Now indicate block diagram. Now instead of 4s2 it become 4s1. What about 3d? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What it indicate? It is exactly what type of orbital? Exactly half filled, because d orbital has capacity of 10 electron. Here how many electrons are present? 5. So it is found to be stable due to exactly half filled orbital. Let us shift towards another member, that is Cu. How copper is found to be stable, similar to chromium? Atomic number 29. So tell me, as per expectation, argon 4s2, then it become 3d9. 18, 20 plus 9, 29. Now indicate block diagram for 4s, both electron in paired condition. What about 3d9? As per Hund's rule, singly filled. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. What happened? It is neither completely filled nor exactly half filled. So what is the easiest way? In order to have completely filled 3d10, one electron jumps here, and what you are getting? Actual configuration. Now what we can write? Instead of 4s2, 4s1. Instead of 3d9, 3d10. So indicate block diagram. Now instead of 2 electron in 4s, only 1 electron. And what about 3d? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1 electron jumps here, 10. What it indicate? Completely filled. Which orbital? 3d10 orbital. So remember, for MCQ, copper is found to be stable due to completely filled 3d10 orbital. Now check last point. Remember this important wording. Which one? CR and CU shows differences in their which configuration? Expected configuration and actual electronic configuration. So this difference can be better explained on the basis of which rule? Extra stability rule. Remember here, what is condition? 3D5. What about copper? 3D10. What does 3D5 indicate? Exactly half filled. Or 3D10 indicate? Completely filled. Remember these two wording so that we can easily explain what is extra stability rule. Remember for MCQ, those elements which are having either exactly half filled or completely filled outer orbital, these are found to be highly stable. This is according to which rule? Extra stability rule. Tell me two conditions. It should be either exactly half filled or completely filled. Just here, CR shows exactly half filled 3D5 orbital, CU shows completely filled 3D10 orbital. So these elements are found to be highly stable, and that is according to which rule? Extra stability rule.